Hello everyone, and welcome to Science 1 class today. So last time we have done with Science 2 one chapter, chapter number 6, that is classification of plants. Today we are going to talk about Science 1. As you can see in the video, the name of the chapter, the first chapter in the science textbook, is for Law of Motion. As we know, we have three parts: physics, chemistry and biology. The law of motion is considered, or it's part of physics chapter. So what is the subtopics which we are going to talk about in this chapter is motion. We'll understand, after motion, we'll understand what is meant by distance and displacement. And there are very important terms, physics terms, which we are going to understand what is meant by acceleration. And the last part of the chapter, we have Newton's law of motion, some of the examples based on Newton's law of motion, and how are the equations formed and how to derive those equations. So basically it's a bigger chapter compared to what you are doing till 8th standard. So now you should get habituated of doing big chapters like this. So basically two parts are there. One is the motion we are going to talk about, and other is the Newton's law of motion, equations and derivation. So let us try to understand the concept of motion first of all. Now they're telling you to, can you recall? So they're giving us some examples here, and they're telling us to find out in which of the examples the object is in motion or object is stationary. Stationary means it is at one particular point, or it is resting at one particular point. So what are they asking? In which of the following examples can you see the motion, and how will you explain the presence or absence of motion? So we need to understand, or they are asking us two basic questions. First of all, from the example, how will you say whether the motion is there? Second one, what is the why are you saying that motion is there or not? So let us take an example. First example, they are saying a flight of a bird. A bird is taking a flight. A bird is trying to fly. So what will we say? First of all, motion is there or not? Yes, motion is there. Why are we saying that motion is there? Because bird is moving from one particular point to another particular point. Second one, a stationary train. A train is halted or stopped at a particular station. Then what you will say, is there any motion in this case? There is no motion here, because train is at that particular position only. So no motion. And why there is no motion? Because train is not moving at all. Third, leaves flying through the air. So there are leaves which are falling from the tree, or some leaves are flying in the air. So can we say the motion is there? Yes, obviously we will say that motion is there. Why? Because the leaves are flying. They are moving from one place to another because of the air, and therefore the motion is there. And the fourth example they are telling us, a stone lying on a hill. A stone is there on the hill. If I see it today, if I see it tomorrow also, that stone is going to be there only. So very obvious, it is not in the motion because it is not moving from that particular point. So two things we have understood, that if object is in motion, it will show the movement, or it will change its position from one place to another. I hope the concept of motion is very clear. So what have they given this purple box? We see the motion of several objects every day. Sometimes we cannot see the motion of an object directly, as in case of breeze. Now suppose you are standing in one room and suddenly cold air comes and touches your body. Are you able to see the breeze? Are you able to see the air? No. But that air is in motion, and that's why you are able to feel that particular air. So similarly they are asking you, so this is a homework part. Can you list other examples of motion besides those given here? So other than these four examples what we have discussed today, I want you to give another five examples from day-to-day life which shows there is a motion. So please remember, this is as a homework, so I'm writing it homework here. You are going to give five examples from day-to-day life which shows that the motion is there. I hope till here the part is very, very clear. So with that, let us get introduced to two important terms: what is meant by displacement and what is meant by distance. You always say, no, I have come to the school traveling so and so distance. I am coming to the school traveling a distance, or covering a distance of 1 kilometer. So that is understanding of distance. But is the distance and displacement the same? We are going to answer this based on what is given in the textbook. So the next part, so the next part is here, it's written.